Today we're going to make this truck perform worse. Thanks for watching. Today we're going to make this truck perform worse. This is my Axial Gladiator. If you want to see me do an unboxing of this, go check out the link that I put over here in the right top of your screen. If you want to see me run it, click this here link. And if you want to stay ahead of what I'm doing over here, or stay up to date at least, make sure that you hit the subscribe button. This truck is a lot of fun, comes with a ton of features, like for example a portal axles dig. It has everything in that, also the Jeep purists say, yeah, but a real Jeep doesn't have portal axles, which is true. So if you want to make it more scale, right now Axial offers a standard axle conversion kit, which is also what I will be putting onto this truck today. Portal axles are great. They really are. They make you go places where usually you would have a hard time going. But in that also, I think it takes away some of the fun. If you have friends, perhaps you do have some friends, and when you're out running on one of your regular trails, when you're trail trucking, then maybe you know that if you have like a standard path that you like choosing, that there's always a couple of instances where you just know that you're going to run into trouble with your axles, and I think that that's part of the fun. Now, if you're out with friends that have, for example, non-portal axle trucks, or you just like to have like a bit of a challenge, then having a portal axle truck really greatly ruins a lot of that fun, because your friends will stand there trying to come over this route or like a little rock, and then you just went over it just like that without even looking because you have portal axles. So just to put some of that fun back into trail trucking, Axial has now solved that by offering this standard axle kit. So you get standard AR45 axles. It comes in a beautiful box. It's like ridiculous. If you look at this, I'm not sure if the person who designed this and this this box had this in mind as like an engagement gift for the partner or whatever, because this is really, this is like beyond nice. This looks way too good for it to just house some axle shocks and some links. Now, I will go check this out. Hopefully it comes with a manual as well, because I saw there are some different links in there too. Then I will take these stock axles, these stock portal axles off, put the standard axles, so the straight axles on, put some different wheels and tires on here as well, because that will also be an option, which you currently don't really have with these portal housings. So those portal boxes, they do take up quite a chunk of space, greatly limiting your wheel options. So we have all the options in the world after this conversion is done, which is great. Well, apart from the drive shaft, I have the front axle in. A couple of observations so far. I think the most noteworthy one is the fact that in those portal axles, your links, but also your shock bottoms, they would line up. So they go through the exact same mounting hole, and they have separated those two with those new standard straight axles, so with those regular AR45 axles. A tiny bit of a geometry shift in the front, so you need to lengthen up your lower links and also your top link. You get a new Panhard mount, but you also get a new Panhard bar, so that is quite interesting. And apart from that, it looks really sturdy. So this axle, compared to some of the AR44 axles perhaps, with this built-in truss, it's really, it's a high quality item. One thing that I'm kind of wondering about, perhaps you can help me out in the comments, perhaps you have seen some other videos or spoken to somebody who has done this standard axle conversion. I don't see the need to replace the shocks. So these shocks, They fully cycle. If you want to, you could, of course, mount the top of the shock in a different location, since there is five different mounting locations for those shock tops. But I don't see the need to replace these. So I will just be running these 90 millimeter shocks just to get my truck to sit a bit lower and a bit more realistically as well. And I will just keep these 100 millimeter shocks as spares. If you want to prank somebody, give them this piece of foam, because the bottom of it is sticky and it will really mess up your hands. So that's one of those nice practical jokes that's also built into this engagement gift box that Axial presents us with. I will now replace the rear axle. One footnote, one of the last steps that you're going to take, just because this is how it's depicted in the manual, is you're going to crack open your transmission case. Now, when you do that, when building it back together, make sure that you do one thing, and that is in this bottom of your motor mount, you want to put those two screws in, just to avoid losing this nut. You don't want to lose your nuts. You avoid you losing this nut on the inside of your spur gear case. What you need to do over here, you need to crack this whole assembly open. There's an idler gear that sits in the middle of it. Usually it is a one-to-one ratio that goes on between those gears. There's a ton of reduction going on inside of those portal axles. Now, seeing that we got rid of the portal axle, we also got rid of that reduction. So that reduction right now needs to happen inside of this case. So that's why we want to replace those gears. Now, when you do that, make sure that you grease them up a tiny bit. That's also the only thing that's not included with this entire conversion package. So have some grease handy, grease them up, build everything back together. Well, like I said, put those two screws in just so you secure those nuts, put this back together, drop the entire assembly back in, and you're done. Well, and just like that, this is a less capable truck than it was before. One thing I do need to tell you is make sure that when you drop the transmission case back in and you hook your drive shafts back up, that everything is in phase, so you have the most smooth running drivetrain possible. In phase means that everything faces the same way, the same direction. That way everything turns nicely. Another thing that I need to tell you about is that I really like the way it sits currently. So I chose to go with a bit smaller wheel and tire combo than I had on this previously. Previously I was running Vanquish Bullies with a larger BF Goodrich tire. These BF Goodrich licensed tires are also made by Proline. These are the all-terrain KO2s, I think. Yes. All-terrain TA KO2s. I'll make sure that there's a link in the video description box so you can find those. These are a bit narrower, a bit less tall. I think they look a bit more scale. They have a very scale looking profile, and especially now that the truck has dropped a bit, I think it looks, well, a tiny bit more realistic and a bit more real world like than it did before. So I really like that. I'm also really excited to start and test these straight axles, seeing that I think they fit a bit more with my style of driving and with my expectations. We have, of course, lowered the center of gravity a tiny bit. We have also we have less clearance currently, but I think it poses a nice challenge in running this truck. So about that as well, really excited. And another thing I'm really excited about, almost drooling, are these wheels. These wheels are made by Spec RC. This is their logo. These come so well packaged as well. So everything comes in is a foam. It comes with like a really clear instructions. Not sure where I put those because I'm really bad at instructions. Over here, made in America, with pride, and it really shows. When I saw these pop up on Instagram at some point, it really struck me that it's an original design, so it's really new. These, for example, this is like a split six. I'm not sure if you're familiar with, for example, the Proline split sixes, which go out to the sides. And these are kind of slotted split sixes. So there's like a bit of a deeper slot that then houses two different slots, if that makes any sense. I'll make sure that you see a close-up of these. These are anodized in like a hot orange. And I think that it looks really great. It will look even better, I think, on this truck if I do something with the paintwork. So what I want to do is perhaps add some orange in the next video or in the video thereafter, just to complement these Spec RC wheels a bit more. And if you want to have more information about these wheels, make sure that you check out the links in the video description box. There's some really nice pictures on their Instagram. They offer a ton of different designs, have a really nice website. So go have a look over there. If you're on the Proline Racing website, you want to have a set of these BF Goodrich All-Terrain KO2 tires, make sure that you use the code HEMISTORM10 also for any of your other Proline needs. HEMISTORM10 or HEMI10 will get you an instant 10% discount. So you can also pass that around to your friends. That doesn't hurt at all. And if you want to have more info about this Axial Jeep JT Gladiator, also go have a look in the video description box, because I will make sure that there's a link over there. I think this is coming along nicely. It sits way more appropriate for what I want to do with this truck. And I also think that it will be a lot more fun to drive it currently, just because it poses a bit more of a challenge. And the challenges are definitely nice, because if they weren't, I would be having an airbrush by now. If you're not subscribed yet, please do, because it is free. It will always stay free. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like button before you leave. And if you have any questions or comments, hit me up in the box below and we'll try to get back to you. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Stay safe. Bye-bye. Back on.